As mentioned, Corey Schneider gets a second straight start for the Canucks. And can you imagine the reaction a couple of years ago if Roberto Luongo was relegated to backup status for consecutive games? Roberto wouldn't be happy. Fans would be stunned. Alain Vigneault would be grilled by the media. But these are different times in Vancouver, and Luongo is a different man. Here's Dan Murphy.
Roberto Luongo is making a case for himself to go back as the number one goalie.
Oh, what a save by Luongo!
Rashad Luongo with the glove.
His positioning has been good. He's been so calm. It's been vintage Roberto Luongo.
First star from your Vancouver Canucks number one, Roberto Luongo.
Roberto Luongo is putting up some impressive numbers this season. But then again, he's done that every year he's been with the Canucks. So why is it that so many people think he's bounced back and reclaimed his status as one of the best goalies in the world?
At the end of the day, I think a lot of it is perception. And sometimes, you know, when you see somebody maybe in a different view, you know, you have different feelings about it. But I definitely feel better as a goalie. That goes without saying. But, you know, in general, I always thought I was a pretty decent goalie.
Off the ice, perception is you're a different person. Do you feel like you've changed over the last 1-2 years?
I think I'm the same person. You know, maybe what people see now is something they didn't see back, but I was still that person, and maybe they didn't really see it.
And the reason no one saw it is because Luongo didn't show it. Instead, we saw a guy who seemed cocky or arrogant, and if things weren't going well, short and brooding.
Sometimes you get so involved in your little bubble that, you know, you feel that, you know, things are bad, but, you know, in the bigger picture, you know, you're an NHL player and you're playing in the best league in the world, and shouldn't be all that bad no matter what the circumstances is.
And let's face it, the circumstances this season are different. Luongo didn't expect to be a Canuck, yet he continues to share the crease with Corey Schneider, the goalie re-signed to replace him. And let's not forget, because you know he hasn't, Luongo has been trade bait since last spring.
I'm approaching it a bit different than I have in the past. You know, whether that's putting less pressure on me, I don't know. I mean, I always like to put pressure on myself to perform. I mean, that's where my pressure comes from. So I just feel that I'm more relaxed and having fun this year and not worried about the results.
Does he do impressions?
I've been doing a pretty good impression of being a backup goalie for the last few weeks, so I think I got that one down pat.
It is easy to see that Luongo is more relaxed. Media scrums are no longer little battles. He's at ease answering the constant questions. Better yet, Luongo can have a laugh at his expense, as we have seen time and time again through one of the best athlete Twitter accounts out there. Self-deprecating doesn't begin to explain the countless tweets he shares through Strombone One. It's clear Luongo isn't taking himself as seriously as before, and people have taken notice.
It's been great. I think a lot of people happy from the way I've handled it. I mean, I've even had a few referees come up to me during games and talk to me and stuff like that. So, you know, I'm happy that it's getting positive feedback. I mean, it could have been a pretty messy situation if it would have been otherwise. And I'm happy that, you know, things have gone the way they have. And you know, we don't know where the future is going to go. But, you know, one thing's for sure is I'm having fun playing the game.
I've been pumping his tires ever since the series started, so I haven't heard anyone. And one nice thing he had to say about me, so that's the way it is.
I didn't realize it was my job to pump his tires.
2011 Stanley Cup Final. Anybody outside of Vancouver, if you said, who would you rather have a beer with, Tim Thomas or Roberto Luongo? I'm saying most people have said Tim Thomas. Now it's completely switched.
I know, it's crazy, right? You know, and that's one of the things that I was, you know, referring to is obviously I don't think I handled myself very well in the finals there with some of the comments I made, and you know, that, if anything, that was the biggest disappointment for myself as the way I approached certain situations in the final. And you know, sometimes you learn from your mistakes. Unfortunately, that was a time that was pretty crucial, but you know, that's life.